Hello, sports fans and baseball fans and fans of Strat-O-Matic Baseball. I'm here with another Mismatch Monday. And today's Mismatch Monday is going to be the truest of mismatches. Today we're going to have the Hall of Famers played with my Hall of Fame set and a team that I put together against the Underdogs, which will be will consist of various players from various bad teams in the past who also did not have very good years. And we will go down the lineups in a minute and look at those. You can see the setup here. So, and I've got the, I want to point out the scoreboard. It says home and away, and the visiting team, the away team, will be the All-Stars, the Hall of Fame, the Hall of Famers. So let's take a look at the lineups. You can see right there, there's the scoreboard up top. And then for the Hall of Famers, they're going to have Jesse Burkitt leading off and playing left field. Earl Averill will bat second and play center field. Ernie Banks will bat third and be the first baseman. Hank Aaron in the cleanup spot. He's the DH. Yes, we are using a DH today. Roberto Clemente will be the right fielder. And then batting sixth will be Home Run Baker, and he will be the third baseman. Rod Carew will bat seventh. He's the second baseman, and he is a bad fielder. That's about the only chink in this team's armor. And then Luke Appling will bat eighth, and he's the shortstop. And then Roger Bresnahan will be the catcher. For the Underdogs, and Jack Chesbro, we can see Jack Chesbro will be the pitcher for the Hall of Famers. For the Underdogs, Jim Wynn will lead off and be the left fielder. Then you've got Pete Washington. I think he's from a Negro League team. He'll be the center fielder. Miguel Cabrera, last year's Miguel Cabrera from Detroit, will be the DH. Michael Chavis from last year's Pirates will be at first base. Willie Castro from last year's Detroit Tigers will be the shortstop. Jaime Candelario, again from last year's Detroit Tigers, will be the third baseman. Mike Ryan from the 1965 Boston Red Sox will be the catcher. Jonathan Scope from last year's Detroit Tigers will be the second baseman. Now, he's going to be a very good defensive second baseman, but he had an off-year hitting. And then Dave May will be in right field and batting ninth. And so that is their lineup, and their pitcher today will be, did I even write him in? Yes, I did. Lefty Tiant, and Lefty Tiant is from a Negro League team, and he will be pitching for the Underdogs. Now, if you watch, Coach DKM's channel, he has a series where he takes an all-time great pitcher and pitches them against a less than competent team of hitters to try to get them, to try to get the pitcher a no-hitter. And he has referred to the other team, at least in one video that he did, the Nolan Ryan video, he referred to them as the dum-dums. But I chose to be a little bit more... a little bit less harsh, and didn't call them the dum-dums. I'm calling them the Underdogs. So with that, we're going to get on with this. And we are using advanced, the advanced game. And we're using the DH. And let's see. Yeah. So I think we are, with all of that said, we're ready to go. The first pitcher on the mound is Lefty Tiant for the Underdogs, and he is, he was a Negro League star, and this particular year for the 1935 New York team, he was 12-12 with a 5.07 earned run average. And he's going to be facing that lineup that I just discussed with you. Jesse Burkett is the first batter. And he gets a 1-4. He is a left-handed batter facing a left-handed pitcher. And that is going to be a ballpark single. And it is a single. And by the way, this isn't going to be a specific ballpark. I'm just going to go by the fact. I'm just going to go by a fictitious ballpark that is a 1-10 for singles for everybody and a 1-10 for home runs for everybody. And that was a 10, so he did get a single. Burkett is aboard with a hit. And that brings up Earl Averill. And he gets a 6-6. He is a lefty, and that is going to be a double. So Earl Averill hits a double. One problem we're going to have that we may run into here is that the innings may not end. So anyway, he gets a double. And the runner on first, Burkett, goes to third. And so you got runners at second and third already with no outs. And Ernie Banks, who wanted to play two, but we're only playing one today, he gets a 1-11. And that's going to be a fly ball to left field B, which knocks in a run. It would have been a ballpark homer. But the homer was 1-10, and that was a 15. So the runner, Burkett, does score, and that is a sack fly for Banks. And Hank Aaron is the batter. Hank Aaron comes up, and he gets a 5-7. He is a right-handed batter, and that is going to be a ground ball to the second baseman, and the second baseman is a 1, and that is a 17. We're going to have to see what happens on that. And that is going to be a ground ball A, but the runner is at second, so he just stays where he is. And Aaron goes 4-3. And that brings up Roberto Clemente. And there's two down. And he gets a 3-10. And 3-10 against a lefty is going to be a fly ball B. So fly ball to left field. So that is going to be an F7. And they get the Hall of Famers get one run and two hits in that inning. And that brings up Jim Wynn for the Underdog. And pitching for the Hall of Famers is Chesbro. Chesbro, lifetime record was 198 and 132, and he had a 268 earned run average. And Jim Wynn the batter. And change that to a 1 and make this the first inning. Want to make sure I keep that up to date. 1-10 and against a righty is going to be a fly ball center field B. So that's going to be an F8. Washington is up. Pete Washington. Now, Pete Washington, I mentioned he was on, he was on in the Negro Leagues, and he was on the 1934 Philadelphia team. He hit 225 and 503 at bats with 14 homers. And he gets a 3-9 against a righty. And that is going to be a home run. Pete Washington hits a home run off Jack Chesbro. Although, is that really unbelievable? I mean, he did hit 14 home runs that year. So Cabrera is the next batter, and we're going to have to make sure that we make it quite clear that that the Underdogs have tied the game. And let me move this over. Might as well move it over so you can see it a little better. And Miguel Cabrera is up. He gets a 1-6, and that is going to be a fly ball center field B, two away. And Michael Chavis is up. And Michael Chavis gets 3-8. And that is going to be a ground ball to the back to the pitcher. And Chesbro throws the ball on to Banks. 1-3. But they get one run on one hit and tie the game. So it's 1-1 after going to the second inning. Roberto Clemente is the batter. He gets a 6-7. He is a right-handed batter, and that is going to be a strikeout. Oh, wait a minute. Nope, that was Home Run Baker, but he's a left-handed batter, and a 6-7 for him would be a walk. All right? So he draws a walk, and Tiant thought he had gotten out of that, was on his way to getting out of this inning, but maybe not now. Rod Carew, really good hitter, not a very good fielder at second base. And he gets a single double asterisk. So runners are again at the corners, as they were after the first two batters of the last inning. And Luke Appling is the batter. He gets a 5-6. He is a righty. That is going to be a strikeout. So there's one down. And Roger Bresnahan, the catcher for the Hall of Famers, he gets a 4-7. Righty. That is going to be a ground ball, first base B. But it does score the run. He's safe at first. Fielder's choice. And the run does score. And the Hall of Famers take another lead. And then Jesse Burkitt is up. Back to the top of the lineup. And he gets a 5-4. And that is going to be a fly ball center field. The center fielder is a 2. That is a 10. So let's see what that is. That's going to have to be on his error card. That is going to be an E2. It's a two-base error. So two-base error puts a man at second and third now. That was an E8, and it moves Carew all the way over to third. But there are two down, and Earl Averill, the batter, and he gets a 1-8. Against a lefty, and that's a strikeout. So he gets out of the inning without any further damage, but one run did come, another run came in, and they got another one hit. They got one more hit. So they have 3 hits and 2 runs, the All-Stars do. And let me mark this down here too. I mean, I'm losing track here, but bottom of the second inning, and the away team does have 2 runs, so let's keep that up to date. So many moving parts I've got going on here. And Willie Castro is the batter. He gets a 1-9, and against a righty, that's going to be a strikeout. So Willie Castro with the K. Candelario comes up, Heimer Candelario. He was a switch hitter, and in 2022, he hit .217 with 13 home runs. And he gets a 2-8, and that is going to be a ground ball pitcher A. So he goes out 1-3, and that brings up Mike Ryan, the catcher for the 19... Where did that... Oh, Where's the white dice? The column dice. Oh, there it is. Mike Ryan in 1965 hit 159 with 3 home runs. Let's see what he can manage here. 4-8. He is a right-handed batter. And that is going to be a walk. So he works a walk. I got to say, these underdogs are kind of holding their own here early. Scope comes up and he gets a 5-5. He is a right-handed batter. And that is going to be a ground ball to the shortstop. The shortstop for the All-Stars is Appling, and he is a 2. That is a 16, and 16 and 2 at shortstop is going to be a ground ball A. So he is out. He goes 6-3. And they get no runs and no hits. And the score is 2-1, Hall of Famers going to the third. And Ernie Banks is the batter, most famously of the Cubs, although I think he started his career briefly on the Cardinals. Is that right? He gets a 110, and that's going to be a home run. And no, it's not. Well, it's a... No, actually, it is. It's a ballpark homer, and it was a good homer for... Even for this ballpark, that's 1-10, so he does get a home run. And that brings up Roberto Clemente, and let's make sure we... Let everybody know that they got another run. Hank Aaron, no. No, Hank Aaron is up. Hank Aaron gets a 4-7. 4-7 for a righty against Tiant is going to be a single. So Aaron is aboard with a hit. That brings to the plate Roberto Clemente. He gets a 6-5. He is a right-handed batter. That is going to be a double. And we're just going to stop the runner at third. I mean, there's no need this, for these guys to rub it in, I don't think. And, that was Clemente. Okay, Clemente had the double. Aaron was aboard with the single and goes to third. And so now Home Run Baker is up. And he gets a 6-8. And 6-8 for a lefty, that is going to be a strikeout. Baker strikes out. That's the first out for the Hall of Famers. And Rod Carew is now the batter. He gets a 5-2. He is a left-handed batter. And that is going to be a ground ball second base A. That's 2 out. He goes 4-3. And that gives way to Luke Appling. And Luke Appling gets a 5-8. He is a righty. And that is going to be a ground ball to the shortstop. So he goes 6-3. They get 3 hits and 1 run that inning. And they are now leading 3-0. Although, that's at, or 3-1. But that's actually pretty good for considering the disparity between these two teams. And also, we are in the bottom of the third inning, yeah. So, Dave May is up for the underdog team. He gets a 3-6 against a righty, and that's going to be a line out to first base. Line out 3, and up steps Jim Wynn, 1 down. He gets a 6-7. He's a righty that is going to be a ground ball shortstop A, so he goes out 6-3. And Pete Washington. Pete Washington gets a 2-6, and that's going to be a ground ball first base B. Ground out 3, and no runs come in for the underdogs, and they didn't get any hits. We're going to the fourth inning. Yeah. Going to the fourth. Score is 3-1. Actually, still pretty reasonable. And yeah. And Roger Bresnahan, I have, is the next batter. And that is the case, yes. And he gets a 1-4 against a lefty, and that is going to be a walk. Bresnahan is aboard. He draws a walk. Jesse Burkitt is up. He gets a 2-6 against a lefty. That is going to be a single double asterisk. Again, they have runners at first and third. And Earl Averill is the batter. He gets a 2-5, and that is going to be a double. Double to right field. Scores one run. We'll stop that guy, though. There's nobody out yet anyway. So you got runners at second and third with nobody out. One run already in this inning, and Ernie Banks, the batter. And he gets a 1-7, and that is going to be a single double asterisk. Oh, wait a minute. It is still going to be a single double asterisk and knock in both runs. And then Hank Aaron is the batter. So, let's see. Three runs have scored already, so we're all the way up to 6. Now, the scoreboard only goes to 9, so we're probably going to lose track after 9 because I don't see this team stopping at or before 9 runs. Hank Aaron gets a 5-5. He is a right-handed batter. That is going to be a ground ball shortstop. The shortstop is a 4. That is a 20. 20 and 4, it might be an out. It is an out, but it's a ground ball B, so it's a fielder's choice. Fielder's choice. And Clemente is up. One down, that's a 6-3. He's a righty. That is going to be a single. So that moves Banks to second. And home run Baker up, and he gets a 2-3. And that is going to be a single. Wait a minute. No, that's a walk. It's a walk. Same result, though. So the bases now are loaded with one out. And Rod Carew is the batter. He gets a 4-7. He is a lefty. That is going to be a single and not going to run. So another run comes in. That makes it 7, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. And Luke Appling is the batter. They need a double play here is really what they need. 4-9 for a righty, and that's going to be a fly ball right field B that's going to score the runner from third. So there is two out now, but Clemente scored on the fly out to right, and Roger Bresnahan back to the start of the order, to the order that started, the guy that started this inning off. 410, 410 for a righty. That is going to be a catcher card X. The catcher for the bad team is actually a 2. That is a 10 and a 2 at catcher. Nope, we're going to have to look at his error rating. So Mike Ryan's error rating is what? Is an E9. And then we'll roll the two dice. 10. E9, 10 is a ground ball C. So that is the final out. And they get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 runs that inning on 1, 2, 3, 4 hits. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hits. And they now have a commanding lead by a score of 7-1. And the, let's see, put in the 5 runs. Right, yeah. Wait a minute. 4 runs. Put in the 4 runs. They only got 4. Wait, 3, 5. No, they got 5, 6, 7. There is 8. So it's 8-0. All right, so it's 8-0. Put in the 5 runs. We're in the bottom of the 4th. Cabrera is the batter. He gets a 3-9, and that is going to be a strikeout. Chavis is up. He gets a 5-8. That is going to be a ground ball, third base B. So he goes out 5-3. And Willie Castro. Willie Castro gets a 5-12. He is a switch hitter, so he'd be batting left. And that is going to be a fly ball right field B. So they get no runs. Well, let's see. Yeah, they get no runs, no hits. And we go to the top of the 5th. And Jesse Burkett is the batter. We're back at the top of the lineup. And we're actually going to take out Tiant at this point. I think it could be said that he's had enough. We're going to bring in Pete Vukovic from the Chicago White Sox of 1976. He pitched 110 innings, gave up 122 hits, had a 4.65 earned run average. And he is a righty. And he's going to be the new batter. And we need a new die from over here because that other one rolled away. And let's see, Jesse Burkett here in the 5th, yeah. And he gets a 3-5. He is going up against now a righty. And that is going to be a ground ball second base. So he bounces out 4-3. Earl Averill is up. He gets a 4-4. He's a lefty batting against a righty. 4-4 is a ground ball. Third base X. Third baseman for this team is Candelario, and he's 4. And that is a 19. So let's see what 19 and 4 is at third base. That's going to be a ground ball C. So Averill grounds out 5-3. This might be the first 1-2-3 inning for the Hall of Famers. And Ernie Banks up at the plate. And he gets a 2-8. And against a righty, that is going to be a line out to shortstop. And it is. Line out 6. They get no runs, no hits. And the score remains at 8-1 after 5 innings. With Candelario up against Chesbro. Let's see. Yeah, they got nothing there. So, Candelario gets a 6-2. He is batting, let's see. Yeah, and he's a switch hitter, so he'd be batting left. 6-2 is a ground ball to the first baseman. He's a 3. That's an 18. 18 and 3 at first is going to be a ground ball. So he's out. And Mike Ryan is now the batter. He's walked this game. And that's all he's done so far. 2-7. And against a righty, that's going to be a pop out to shortstop. And Jonathan Scope is up. Jonathan Scope with a 2-11 against a righty, and that is going to be a line out to shortstop. So he lines out. Line out 6. They get no runs. They get no hits. And they get, they get no runs. And we're going to the top of the 6th. And the score is still 8-1. Vukovic out there. Now, Vukovic was a starter reliever, so he does have the stamina to keep going a little bit here. And he had a 1-2-3 inning back in the 5th against these guys, so you got to think that's, you know, they want to see that keep going. 5-12, Hank Aaron, 5-12. He's a right-handed batter, and that is going to be a ground ball to first. The first baseman for this team is Chavis, and he is a 3. That is an 11. And that's going to be on his air rating, so we'll see what Chavis's air rating is. It is an E6. Not bad. We'll roll the dice. That's an 8. And that is going to be a ground ball double. It would have been a double play if there had been somebody on, but it isn't. But it is a ground ball, so a ground out. So Aaron, I guess, was the first batter, right? Yeah. And he grounded out to first base. And Clemente is up. And he gets a 6-6. He's a righty against a righty. And that is going to be a fly ball center field B. So he flies out 8. And Vukovic, man, these guys, the Hall of Famers, really can't solve Vukovic. Home Run Baker is the batter. He gets a 1-7, and that is going to be a single. Yes. So that's the first hit they've gotten off of Vukovic. And Rod Carew is up. Rod Carew gets a 4-11. He is a lefty. And 4-11 is going to be a walk. So that sends Baker to second. Carew with the walk and Appling the batter. Luke Appling, the shortstop, is the batter. Two out, two on. And he gets a 2-7. And that is going to be a single to Balastris. And so they do strike, they do get through on Vukovic. And that's another run. And like I say, any other runs from here on out, we really can't keep on the scoreboard up here. Hopefully you've been following along. 4-8 for Bresnahan. And that is going to be, he's a right-handed batter. That is going to be a single and not going to run. So it looked like Vukovic might, it looked like he might be able to get out of this inning, but now he's given up two runs and Burkett is the batter. Jesse Burkett. He gets a 2-4 and that is going to be a, that looks like it's a home run. It's a home run. So Burkett gets a 3-run jack. So he really didn't get out of the inning. Not even at all. And I can't do that on the scoreboard because the scoreboard only goes to 9. And Earl Averill is up with the bases cleared and he's a 3, that's a 3-4 and that is going to be a fly ball to left field. F9, but they do get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 runs right there. And how many hits? 1, 2, 3, 4 hits. So it is, let's see, 4, yeah. So it's 13 to 1 going to the bottom of the 6th. Dave May is the batter. He gets a 4-9, and that's going to be a, it's going to be a ground ball to second base for Dave May, 4-3 here in the 6th. Jim Wynn gets a 5-7. 5-7 is going to be a strikeout. And that brings up Pete Washington. And he gets a 6-9 for a lefty. That is going to be a fly ball center field. No runs come in for them. They don't get any hits. They only have, according to this, they only have one hit. Is that right? Yeah. Looks like it is. One hit for the Underdogs so far off of Chesbro. I think we'll take Chesbro out next inning. But right now, we're going to keep going along. Vukovic is still going to stay out there. Ernie Banks, no wonder he would want to play 2 today. He's actually had a pretty good day. He's got a home run and a single. He's 2 for 3. And he also had a sack fly run batted in. He gets a 2-3, and that is going to be a, that's going to be a line out to first base. It would have been a single, but this is a, it's a, that was a ballpark single though. And, it didn't work. It didn't go through. Hank Aaron is up with one down and he gets a 6-7 for a righty. That is going to be a ground ball second base. He is a 1. That is an 8. So I wonder what that is. That we got to look at his card. Got to look at Scope's error rating. And his error rating is just a 4. So we roll the dice. It's a 7. And that is going to be... let's see. That's going to be... Wait, we rolled a 7. Yeah, it's going to be a ground ball. So 4-3 for Aaron. And Clemente up. And he gets a 4-4. He's a righty. 4-4 is going to be a ground ball third base. Third baseman is a... 4, that is a 2, that's probably going to be a hit. That is a single, yes. So Clemente gets a hit and Home Run Baker is up. Home Run Baker gets a 5-10. He's a lefty. And that is going to be a catcher card X. The catcher is a 2. That is an 8. And that's going to be a pop out. So he gets another 0 inning on these guys. But still, I mean, they did get a, they, you know, I mean, the lead is 13-1. So let's not get too happy about it. But anyway, we're going to take Chesbro out of the game. Chesbro has, you know, that was a nice tune-up for him. But now we're going to bring in someone else to pitch. And, nobody really knows about him. We're going to bring in Stan Kovaleski. Stan Kovaleski lifetime was 215 and 142 with a 288 earned run average, and he is a right-handed pitcher, just like Chesbro was. Miguel Cabrera is the batter. We are going now to the seventh. I got so many moving parts here that I got to keep track of. It's 13-1, not 9-1 like the scoreboard says. Again, the scoreboard only goes to 9. So, but tune in and see how many runs end up being scored in the end here. But yeah, Cabrera is the first batter that's going to face Kovaleski. And that is a 6-3, and he is a righty, and 6-3 is going to be a ground ball to the shortstop. So that's going to be 6-3. Michael Chavis is up. He gets a 4-7 righty. That's going to be a line out to third base. And Willie Castro with 2 down, and that is a 6-2. He is a switch hitter, so he'd bat left. And that is going to be a fly ball to center field. And no runs come in, no hits, and they still only have 1 hit. So that's another thing to watch. Could be a combined. In fact, I really shouldn't have taken Chesbro out. He could have had a 1 hitter, but, you know. Does it really matter? So we're here in the top of the eighth. So moving along to the eighth, it's 13-1. And I guess they're going to take Vukovic out. He's probably had enough by now. And they're going to bring in Manny Banuelos from Pittsburgh of 2022. He was 2-1 with a 4.96 earned run average. And he is a left-handed pitcher. And Home Run Baker comes up. He gets a 5-4. Lefty on lefty is going to be a fly ball to center. The center fielder is a 2. That is a 16. So let's see what happens there. That is going to be a fly ball. So that was... Wait a minute. That was supposed to be Carew. All right. It's still lefty on lefty, so the result is the same. He flies out. Appling is up. Appling is up, and he gets a 6-8. 6-8 is a righty, and that is going to be a, that's going to be a double. Appling rips the double, and Bresnahan comes up with a man at second now with one out. He gets a 5-8, and he is going to have a single double asterisk and knock in a run. Again, can't change the scoreboard. That's as high as it goes. Burkett is the batter. And he gets a 2-2, which is going to be a hit by pitch. That moves Bresnahan to second. And there is one out. And Earl Averill comes up. He gets a 3-8. 3-8 against a lefty is going to be a single double asterisk and score a run. Moves runners to first and third. And Ernie Banks is the batter. He gets a 6-7. He is a righty. That is going to be a strikeout. So that's the second out. Two away. And Hank Aaron. Hammerin' Hank gets a 5-3. He is a righty. That is going to be a fly ball right field X. The right fielder is a 3. That is a 16. And 16 and 3 is going to be a fly ball. So he flies out. But they get 2 runs on 1, 2, 3 hits. Ton of hits for these guys. And so they did get 3 more runs. Or 2 more runs, 3 hits. Oh, I'm way behind here on this scoreboard. So here they just got 2 runs, and we're going to the bottom of the 8th. And Condelario is the batter. He gets a 3-6-3 against a righty. He would be batting left. That is going to be a single. That's their second hit. Mike Ryan is up. He gets a 6-6. That is going to be a double. So Mike Ryan hitting a double. And Mike Ryan not having a bad day. Scope gets a 4-4. That is going to be a catcher card X. Their catcher is a 1, and that's a 17. That's a foul out. And Dave May is the batter. Runners at second and third, 1 out. And he gets a 1-9, which is going to be a ground ball, second base, A. That's 2 away in the runner's hold. And Jim Wynn, back to the start of the lineup. Jim Wynn gets a strikeout. So they get no runs, but they did get 2 more hits. We go to the top of the 9th. Top of the 9th with a score a lot to very little. And Hank Aaron, no, Clemente is the batter. He gets a 5-3. That is going to be a fly ball right field. The right fielder is a 3. That is a 15. Probably not good. Oh, it is. Fly ball. So Clemente flies out. Which brings up home run Baker. One away. That is a 2-8. And that's going to be a single. Rod Carew is a batter. One on, one out. He gets a 1-8. That's a single double asterisk. Puts runners at the corners. Luke Appling is the batter. He gets a 3-8. That is going to be a walk. Wait a minute. Yep, it's a walk. So the bases are loaded here with one out. And Bresnahan is the batter. He gets a 3-10. 3-10 is going to be a hit by pitch and force in a run. And Justin Burkett, top of the order. It's a 1-3. That's a ground ball. First base A. So that will be a double play and end the inning. And they got one run on two hits. And we go to the bottom of the ninth. Pete Washington is up. He gets a 4-10, left-handed batter, center field fly ball. He is a 1, that is a 6, probably an out. And it is. Cabrera's up, he gets a 2-11, that's going to be a ground ball pitcher B, so 1-3. And that brings up Michael Chavis. And he gets a 5-7. Righty on righty, that's going to be a ground ball. No strikeout. So, that is going to be the game. No runs come in, so the final score is 5-10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 to 1. The Hall of Famers have beaten the Underdogs 16-1. The hits is too many to count for the Hall of Famers. For the Underdogs, they had 3 hits. For these guys, they had 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15, 16, 19, 21 hits. So 21 hits for the Hall of Famers, 3 hits for the Underdogs. Final score, 16-1, and that's going to be it for me, Sportsman Z, Bob Zolke, signing off.